Have you been to your local sporting goods store or archery shop lately and tried to pick out an open reed cow call? In this video, we're gonna break down the differences to help you decide right after this. Hey everybody, Michael Batiste from the Elk Calling Academy, where we give you your blueprint for success in the elk woods. On this channel, we do elk call reviews, gear reviews, elk calling lessons, tips, and tutorials just like this one. So if you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing so you don't miss out on future videos. All right, so there you are, standing in front of the wall of confusion again, trying to figure out what's the right open reed cow call. And why are there so many options? What's the difference? We're gonna go through those. So an open reed cow call is a very effective tool. Now, even though a lot of people or a majority of the people like to use diaphragm reeds, they still carry open reed cow calls as they do have a benefit. They give a different pitch, a different tone, and there are advantages to carrying them. But what's the difference between all of them? I mean, there's plastic barrels, wood barrels, and now coming out on the market is acrylic barrels. There's skinny reeds, there's fat reeds, there's single reeds, double reeds, tapered reeds, tone converters, non-tone converters, ported barrels. It's confusing. So really the purpose of an open reed cow call, as I mentioned earlier, is just to give you a different pitch and tone to your cow sounds from what you use with a diaphragm. And also there are some people that have such a gag reflex or they're allergic to latex that they can't use diaphragm reeds, so open reed cow calls are your only choice. Now, what I mean by the reed itself, here are three examples. So you have a tapered reed, a narrow reed, and then a wide reed. When it comes to reeds, what's the difference in the shape? So typically a narrow reed will be a little higher pitched and have a little bit more volume, where your wider reed will be mellower and softer. But on the flip side, the narrow reed takes less pressure with your lips and your air to operate versus the wide reed. The wide reed will take more lip pressure and air pressure. The tapered kind of gives the best of both worlds. Now, the way that's an advantage is on a shelf of an open reed cow call, if you're all the way out here on the tip, it's your higher notes, the middle kind of mid note, and then low note. So you can place your lips in different places to play different notes. Now, a lot of these will have these green bands on them. What those are is those are lip positioners and tuning bands, meaning when you get a call, you can actually move that forward and backwards on that to tune that call to what you like. Once you get that tuned, then it just becomes a lip positioner where you just bump right up against it, and you know where to place your lips every time without actually thinking about it. Now, it doesn't matter if you use your top lip or if you roll these over and use your bottom lip. Everybody's a little bit different in which lip they have more control on. So you'll just have to play with it, top lip and bottom lip, to see what works best for you. Now, once you get to the point that you really understand the different places and positions of what pitches, meaning high note, mid note, low note, all that kind of stuff that you want to do, then you can actually really move this positioner band and really tune this reed to vibrate and play the notes that you like. Okay, as far as the barrel goes, there's skinny barrels, flat, flared barrels, wide barrels. All that does is that's the channel for the sound to come out and how it's going to come out. And there's a lot of different things you can do with them. You can cup your hand and act them as a use them as a magnaphone to amplify the sound. You can close your hand off to mellow it out. But we have wood, we have plastic, and like I said, there's some new calls out on the market that are made out of acrylic. What's the difference between the two and what's, or the three and what's the best? Well, plastic a lot of times can add a little bit of vibration into your calling. So wood is a good advantage over plastic because wood doesn't really vibrate, so your sounds are cleaner. The only thing with wood though is wood is affected by temperature, which means it can expand and contract. It can change the tones of your call a little bit. These are minor changes that we're not really going to pick up on that much, but some you certainly can. Now that's the advantage with some of the new acrylics that are coming out. They finally joined the waterfowl world and decided to start making calls out of acrylic, which aren't affected by the temperatures. Now, we talked about also the tapered reed. The tapered reed is kind of a middle of the road option, where it takes a little bit more lip pressure and air pressure than the skinny, but not quite as much as the wide. Now, tone converter versus non-tone converter. Why do some calls have this tone converter and others don't? What a tone converter does, it acts much in the same as if you take your hand and close it on the end of the call, meaning it mellows it out. And what I mean by that, it just softens that call. The tone converter does the exact same thing. It's just much more effective at toning that call down. Now there's even calls on the market today that have all these ports, these fluted barrels. What's the advantage of that? Well, typically the advantage of that is now when your sound comes into the sound barrel, it actually goes all directions. It expands through each of those holes and just kind of throws your sound out in a more broader area. So what's the best open reed cow call? That is personal preference. I actually carry several different ones because I like a skinny reed on a windy day. So on a windy day, I'm going to pick that narrow reed because they typically are louder. And on windy days, our call and sound doesn't travel as much. So I want something that's going to give me the maximum volume and ability to carry out there. Most of the time though, my personal preference is a wider reed. Reason being is I like those mellower tones because a lot of times, and when I mostly use an open reed cow call is when I'm back behind as the caller and I have that ability that I can go ahead and get away with movements, but I still want that call to be soft and mellow so that that bull thinks that I'm farther away than what I actually am. So you might get a couple of different types and play around and find the one that works best for you. Again, try them with your top lip, try them with your bottom lip to see which one you have the best control in, and then which one you like the sound. I strongly recommend that when you're playing with them and calling on them, go outside, because how a call sounds inside versus how it sounds outside is dramatically different. Inside, those sound waves can really bounce around all the walls and off the ceiling and everything, and it keeps it contained, where outside, it actually expands more. So a call that you blow on inside that you think is really loud and has a real sharp sound to it, once you get outside, you might be surprised that it will actually mellow out quite a bit. Now there's a lot of great brands out there and a lot of great makers. I know Barry Game Call, Native by Carlton, Rocky Mountain Hunting Calls, Phelps, those are some of the more popular brands, the Primos. They all make really good cow calls. So if you have a favorite brand or a call company that you like to support, check out the calls because a lot of them do offer narrow or wide on the reed, so you can get options with that same company that you like. All right, guys, as always, thank you for tuning in to the Beginner's Guide to Elk Calling. We hope you're enjoying this series. If you've missed some of the future episodes, you can actually click right up here and that'll take you into the playlist where you can watch previous episodes of the Beginner's Guide to Elk Calling. If you want some more calling tips, you can click right down here in this corner and you can go to our Wapiti Wednesday Q&A where we get more specific on sounds. Now, if you're still struggling with the diaphragm or you really want to learn more about more of the sounds and how to do them, get a hold of us on the Elk Calling Academy Facebook page and let's set up a one-on-one lesson with you. The nice thing there is we do use an online video conferencing system that we can record and send that session to you, so you always have it to practice to. All right, guys, until next week, keep practicing, keep calling, keep having fun, and we'll see you on the next Beginner's Guide to Elk Calling.